Namaste. Welcome to Hamska Academy. This is Seshu Chira welcoming you back in the session of Delhi Sultanate Rulers or Delhi Sultans. In the previous video, we discussed about how we have five dynasties which together called as Delhi Sultanate Rulers. So five dynasties ruled. Now, how did we come to know about the information about these five dynasties or the rulers of Delhi Sultans and all these aspects? Let us check them now. So how to find out about the Delhi Sultanate rulers, or in simple words, we can say what are the sources that we have to know about the rulers of Delhi Sultanate or Delhi Sultans. First, as we all know, the inscriptions which are there on the walls of the temples, on the walls of any major constructions, all these inscriptions are a major source about the information of Delhi Sultans. Next, the important source what we have is the coins and architecture, the magnificent constructions which are done. As you can see on the screen, we have tombs, then we have Buland Darwazas, and we have Firoz Shah Tughlaq's tomb. How beautifully they all are constructed. Basing on the art and architecture work, coins, inscriptions, these are the major sources of history for us to know about Delhi Sultans. There are also some special and valuable resources which tell us about the histories of Delhi Sultans. They are Tariq, if it is written in a singular, and Tawarik, if it is written in plural. These are the writings written in Persian language, the language of administration under the Delhi Sultans. So during the Delhi Sultans' rule, the administrative language was Persian. That's why the histories are written in Tariq or Tawarik, were written in Persian language. Now, who used to write about these Tariqs or Tawariks? The authors of Tariq or Tawariks were learned men. These people used to work along with the king as secretaries, administrators, poets, courtiers, and they both recounted the events, advised the rulers on the governance, emphasis on importance of just rule. So the people, those who are working with the king and helping him in administration, looking after with the poetic work, court works, and also advising the king on the issues of governance, emphasizing on the importance of just rule, these people are the authors of Tawariks. What do they write in these Tawariks? We came to know what are the sources. We came to know that coins, inscriptions, architecture are the major sources, or a lot of information we get from these particular sources. Now, there are certain valuable histories also. They are called as Tariq or Tawariks. Now, these are written in Persian language. Why they were written in Persian language? Because Persia is the official language of the people during that particular rule. Whose rule? Delhi Sultan rulers. Then, who were the people who wrote this one? The authors of the Tawariks are assisting the kings in administration, who acted as secretaries, poets, artisans, courtiers. All these people used to advise the king on the governance and the importance of just rule. So these people were the authors of Tawariks or Tariqs. Now let us see, how do they make a manuscript? Let us see, how do they make a manuscript? What are the stages in making a manuscript? As you can see on the screen here, there are four stages. Stage 1, Stage 2, Stage 3, and Stage 4. The making of the manuscripts is divided into four stages. The first stage, as you can see here, this stage is called preparing the paper. The bark of the tree is cut and it is softened so that you can write conveniently, because the barks of the trees are round in shape and they are not as a paper. So it has to be compressed and made it as soft paper so that you can write. That is the first thing, first stage. Second stage, you can see here, writing the text. After you make the paper, you will write the text. Once you write the text, then we move to the third stage, that is melting the gold. We melt the gold. Why do you melt gold for making a manuscript? On the manuscript, the words which are important, the words which contain the names of the king or any titles or any other important information will be highlighted using the gold melting. So the gold has to be melted and pour on the letters so that that letters will be highlighted with gold coating. And later we'll do the binding of the manuscript so that it can be preserved carefully. So how many stages are there? Four stages. Stage one, preparation of the paper. Stage two, writing on the text. Stage three, melting gold to highlight the important words and passages. And stage four, we prepare the binding process. So like this, the manuscripts are prepared. There is one famous writing which is called as Circle of Justice. What is it called? Circle of Justice. Who wrote this one? Fakir Mudabbir. Fakir Mudabbir wrote in 13th century that we all are living in a circle of justice. What was that? A king cannot survive without a soldier. Yes, we need a lot of soldiers to safeguard the king and the kingdom. Soldiers cannot live without salaries. Of course, everybody needs money and salaries. Then only we can survive. Salaries come from the revenue collected from the peasants. Yes, the taxes which are paid by the peasants, artisans, are only paid as salaries to the soldiers. But peasants cannot pay revenue only when they are prosperous and happy. So peasants can pay only revenue if they are happy and prosperous. So in order to make them happy, king has to take care of the irrigation works and taxes has to be reduced and everything. So this happens when king promotes justice and honest governance. As I told you, if the king is not honest and giving a justice rule there, people cannot be happy and prosperous. So now, if king has to survive, soldiers have to be there. If soldiers have to be there, soldiers have to be paid salaries. If soldiers have to be paid salaries, then we have to collect taxes from the peasants. If peasants have to pay, then they have to be happy and prosperous. These all are again coming back to king. When the king is just and honest in governance, definitely the peasants will pay the taxes. The taxes will be collected and paid to the soldiers, and the soldiers will safeguard the king, and king will be safe. So it's a continuous circle. That's why Fakri Mudabbir calls it as Circle of Justice. That's all we have in today's session. Please stay tuned. We'll catch you in the next session. Please subscribe.